Warning, intuitive eating can actually be a very dangerous and detrimental thing for someone to start doing. And yes, there is so many people that say that it helps them overcome all different types of binge eating and other eating disorders, especially a lot of people that come from like an extreme calorie restriction diet, or even someone that is overweight and that just eats so many calories and excess of calories, known as a calorie surplus, that just makes them gain weight and has a whole host of negative effects on their mental health and their physical health holistically. And when I make this warning, this is not a broad statement. I'm not saying that it is bad for everyone and no one should do it, but I wanted to go into some reasons as to when it can be bad for someone to do this. So the number one thing that I want to mention is most people are so out of tune with their body. Too many people are in their head and they're just very disconnected from themselves internally fully. And most people have been like this their whole life or the majority of their life. So due to this disconnection from the body and not being able to listen to its signals very well, when you do intuitive eating, which is basically a type of eating where they say just listen to like your inner voice and your body and your inner self of when you actually need to eat, and listen to what foods it wants you to eat and how much to eat, and listen to when you're full and satiated even, and don't eat past the point of satiation, which yes, that can work really, really well. But like I said, if you're not in tune with your body, you might be getting some mixed signals. You might get very, very emotional and just wanna go and eat on this food and this food when your body doesn't need it, and certain foods that are not necessarily healthy for you. It could be easier to overeat as well. And even though you're trying to be as intuitive as possible with your eating, when this is going on, your intuition can go out of the window. Also, you just may be very out of tune with when you're satiated. So you might eat past the point of satiation, or you may be someone that is eating too fast and your body doesn't register you're full until a lot later. So then you could continue eating and actually overeating past the point of satiation and not feel good from it. And there's a few different directions with intuitive eating where it could go wrong. So another example I will make is, say that you're someone that's really used to intermittent fasting and you want to get into intuitive eating. So you're very used to your body naturally suppressing your appetite. So you could get into intuitive eating and you could just not eat the majority of the day and be like, oh, I'm not feeling hungry whatsoever. But that doesn't mean that your body isn't hungry, because I'm someone that does intermittent fasting and I could fast for days and days and days in a row and not feel hungry. But that doesn't mean I don't need to eat, because what will start to happen if I do that is my energy levels will start to drop, my mood won't be as good, my sleep won't be as good, and I just not to feel my best, and I just won't be able to live life to the fullest and feel very vibrant and alive whatsoever, and it could cause a whole host of other negative unwanted effects. And I'm telling you, I used to be someone that used to have an issue with this many, many years ago. I've had certain different eating disorders such as binge eating, and then just massively doing things like extreme calorie restriction, and then beating myself up when I would binge eat, and then just doing things like extreme fast that I didn't actually need to do, because fasting is actually good when it's done for the right reasons and it's done in a safe manner and you're doing it for the right reasons, and you're not just forcing your body to fast when it doesn't need to fast. So yeah, if you're someone that's really not in tune with your body again, and you're someone that's done a lot of intermittent fasting in the past in a way where it was unhealthy for you, and you become very out of tune when you're hungry and not. With intuitive eating, you could think you don't need to eat when you do actually need to eat. And then you've got the opposite end of the spectrum, which is where you could be trying to do intuitive eating, but again, because you're so disconnected from your body, that you could just go in the direction of eating more food than is necessary. And it's very easy to train yourself. I've done this before, where I've been at a point with my diet where I'm not eating that much food and not consistently, and then I'm like, right, I should start eating a lot of food and be in a calorie surplus to gain more weight, because there's been times where I've been very, very skinny. And then I start doing that, and I find after doing that a short period of time, I can just eat so many meals throughout the day, and my body just gets used to that, and then it keeps wanting it over and over and over again. But every time I've done that, what happens. I end up eating too much too consistently. I start to feel very heavy and weighed down, and it just really slows me down completely. It makes me feel very, very sluggish. And man, look at this forest. It's an amazing, lovely walk to be doing with you guys. The three different examples that I would like to personally make. So I'm not saying you shouldn't do intuitive eating, but you want to be really, really aware of some things that could come up for you that could really make intuitive eating not work for you. But this could just happen in the early stages, and as long as you're as mindful and as aware as you possibly can be, and there will be times that you do make mistakes with intuitive eating, as long as you pick yourself up, try again, and try and learn the best from the mistakes that you've made, and keep pushing forward, keep trying. It's like trial and error is the best way to succeed with anything. You can't expect to be a perfectionist and it all just to go completely smooth. No one's done that of anything that they've really wanted to achieve with things such as dietary things, such as intuitive eating. And I can say, over a long period of time of trying out many different diets and doing a lot of inner work and working on loving myself and not hating myself and having self-destructive and sabotage patterns like I used to, and doing inner child work and other various things to actually make me more connected to my emotional body and my inner child and so forth, I managed to, over a long period of time, and I got to this end result years and years ago, where I'm so in tune with my body. I know exactly what it needs and when it needs it. And if there's certain foods that I do eat that maybe I didn't know that I had an intolerance to, or they just don't agree with me whatsoever, when I try them and eat them and they don't make me feel good, I discontinue eating them. And the foods that make me feel the best, I just continue eating them. So I can tell you, I'm a very healthy place with eating. I don't have any eating disorders like I used to years ago. And man, they used to be horrible, because when I used to binge, I just used to beat myself up and then do all these things to just like purge all the food from me, and then go on really restrictive diets afterwards. And it's just like a very, very vicious cycle, which I'm glad does not happen anymore. Which I know for anyone that's currently going through that or has been through it, you'll be able to relate to that and understand that completely. I think there's a frog that just jumped in the water or something. If someone's going to embark on intuitive eating, then just do the best that you can do and learn from as many other people that do intuitive eating out there that have succeeded with it and overcome eating disorders and got a whole host of other amazing benefits. And last but not least, like I said earlier on, that you may not be in tune with the foods that you really should be eating that are going to make you feel the best. So this can be a whole journey with this. Trial and elimination will work, but there may be times where you're very emotionally very stressed out, like you're just fatigued or something else is going on, where you start to become very out of tune with what your body actually needs. So what I would say is, it could be good to combine intuitive eating with a specific diet that is in line with your morals, your ethics, and other various things for you as an individual. Like myself, I eat a vegan, whole food, plant-based diet due to the ethical reasons, the environmental reasons, and the health reasons as well. I managed to heal all my health issues on this diet. I used to have ulcerative colitis, depression, hyperhidrosis, chronic fatigue syndrome, and so forth. And yeah, you can find a diet like I found that works for you and makes you feel good, and combine it with your intuitive eating. So you just say, right, I'm on a ketogenic diet, carnivore diet, or this diet, and just do your best to stick to that diet. And combine it with the intuitive eating in a way where you only eat when you really need to eat. You stop eating when you're at the point of satiating. You don't eat your next meals until you're hungry. And like I said, if you're someone that is just used to hardly eating any food whatsoever and you really suppress your appetite, then that's just something you're going to have to play around with. And what I personally had to do with this is one last thing I want to mention. If you're someone that's coming from that type of background with eating, what I personally do is I just listen to my body, and if I'm not feeling the best, if my energy levels massively drop, my mood's not so good, and I start to feel like moody and all over the place, then normally I need to eat. And it's going to be different signs and symptoms that each individual is going to get from their body when you're not eating enough, or you're not eating enough meals throughout the day. And remember, we're all different. Just because I eat in a specific way and eat a certain amount of calories, certain foods, it may work for me, but it may not work for you. So only your body knows best. And the more you can become in tune with your body, the best relationship you're going to form with food that you ever possibly can, and yourself as well. Because so many people are using food in a way as a form of self-abuse, whether they know that or not. And actually, I'm going to add one last thing. One of the things that have allowed me to become connected to my emotional body and my body so much is doing the completion process by Teal Swan. I put the link down below for her book in case you're interested in that, and her YouTube channel as well. I've worked with one of the practitioners that's trained by her and done so many things to heal the emotional body and childhood traumas and reprogram subconscious beliefs. And that's something that was massively a part of my own healing, so I could have the healthiest relationship with food that I managed to form and still currently have up until this current point. So that's it for this video. If you like the video, like it down below. Don't forget to share with others, and don't forget to subscribe to receive a lot more videos like this from me on a regular basis. Other videos on intermittent fasting, dry fasting, prolonged fasting, weight loss, calisthenics, which is like body weight style type of training. Also videos showing you what I get up to in my life, what I eat in this amazing tropical paradise where I get to live 24/7, which is Koh Phangan, Thailand, one of the best Thai islands in the world, and many other different videos to help you go in a direction to learn effective information that can help you form the healthiest relationship with food, and also for you to go in a direction to gain and maintain the body desire, the fitness levels, the health, and the most optimal cognitive functioning of your brain as well, and get a whole host of other amazing benefits that I've managed to, and many other people that have followed the information from my videos to achieve those results, and many other amazing life transformative benefits as well. So if it sounds good to you, make sure you click the subscribe button down below and you click the bell notification button next to the subscribe button. Otherwise YouTube will not notify you of when new videos are uploaded, and I have new ones coming almost every single day. So yeah, as always, stay fit, stay energetic, and go get those gains. Peace.